always fun here on Local Lifestyles when our movie critic Jim Hunter dropped by. Today, he's going to walk us through some of the hits, the misses, and those yet to come, the still to come category.
The movies of the summer, what was good, what was not so good, maybe didn't find an audience, and then what to look forward to.
Well,
next.
Then please begin. Hold forth.
Well, I think there's no doubt that Avengers Endgame is probably the highlight of the summer. This was a film that came out with a splash. It broke box office. It shattered box office records for opening weekends, both domestic and worldwide. It's challenging Avatar for the highest grossing film worldwide of all time.
It's a yes to that one. And it was good. I mean, it really was good.
It was a good film, and it sort of bookended a part of the MCU. The MCU is obviously continuing this weekend with Spider-Man Far From Home coming out, but Avengers Endgame is still the highlight of the summer so far.
Okay. What's next?
Additionally, Rocketman was a highlight of the summer as well. That's a prestige film, a performance film, so that was a highlight. But moving on to the misses, there have been quite a few. This has actually been a relatively disappointing summer, and we'll start with Brightburn. This was a film that was essentially a dark Superman. What if Superman was evil? This film did not find an audience, and it wasn't very good. Likewise with other horror films like Ma and also Godzilla King of Monsters, which is more of an action horror film than a horror film, but that also didn't find an audience and wasn't very good as well. What has also not found an audience, but I thought were really good, were the comedies this summer.
Booksmart. Okay.
And Late Night. But let's highlight Booksmart, because this is a female-led film directed by Olivia Wilde, starring two, Beanie Feldstein and Caitlin Dever. And this is a fantastic movie. It's a chock full with almost every idea the creators have ever had. And it is, this may very well be a film that people discover on streaming services later on. And this is a film that people will look back on as sort of a highlight. It may be this generation's Breakfast Club, I think. Because
that's a good
really
way to put it. Yeah, you've got to find that and become iconic to this group, and then they just keep playing it.
I hope so.
Yes.
It is an R-rated film, so it goes a little far in some of those areas. But then again, Breakfast Club had its adult content as well.
It certainly did as well, and you see most of the stuff they talk about there on a commercial today. So there you go. All right, what about the things coming up?
Still to come is, well, of course, the Lion King remake.
I'm excited about it.
I think
it
is going to be, this is, with the success of Aladdin has sort of been a sleeper hit over the course of the summer, sort of racking up $10 million every week at the box office, third or fourth place. It's doing well. It's running up the bank. I think the Lion King is well positioned to do some of the same things. And so we'll see what other people have to say about the Lion King, especially the critics. Once Upon a Time in Hollywood.
I just saw the preview to this.
Yes.
Okay,
Quentin Tarantino's film. This is a prestige film that we're looking forward to. Something along the lines of, not like Rocketman, but this might be an Oscar contender, like Rocketman might be an Oscar contender. Once Upon a Time in Hollywood is set. Once Upon a Time in Hollywood.
In Hollywood, as you might imagine.
It follows a story adjacent to Sharon Tate and the Manson murders. Directed by Quentin Tarantino, we'll certainly see what critics have to say about that.
Well, you know it'll be an edgy little number for sure.
Certainly
because Tarantino
will.
Always, thank you as always, Jim.
My pleasure.
The picks, the misses, and that yet to come from our movie critic, Jim Hunter. We'll be back with more Local Lifestyles right after this.